before you leave to go to sea, you need to be prepared for the consequences of things not going well. Because once you get away from land, you really are on your own. The closest people to you are in orbit, overhead. The nearest land with people live on it is thousands of miles away at times.
Scrimshaw, it's a name for the art of engraving on the whale's teeth, on sperm whale teeth. It's scrimshaw, it becomes one of the most important activities on the Azores. These ships, they were the sailing ships. When there was no wind, they would stop in the middle of the ocean. It was a way of passing the time. They just try to work with what the nature and the sea brings to them, what they can find in their trips around the world.
In the middle of these vast expanses, there's still human impact. Even there, where the closest people are in a space station, there's rubbish from us on shore. The biggest thing I find about just being at sea is that you really just reconnect with the cycle of the natural world. If you're out in the middle of the ocean by yourself, you need to take care of your own problems. Unforeseen problems where you've got to repurpose things. When you don't have anything else to rely on, you end up having to become a little bit more inventive.
On the sperm whale was the only thing that was by right for the whalers. And this art, when they arrive at land, they start to sell them and offer us the things that they have made during their crossing of the Atlantic.